In fourth video, we discuss about new Mendelism. Now, next point of topic inheritance and variation is chromosomal theory of inheritance. Gregor John Mendel published his work on inheritance of traits in 1866, but for some reasons it remained unnoticed or unrecognized till 19,000. As communication was not easy in those days, his work was not widely recognized. His approach of using mathematics and statistics to explain biological phenomena was totally new and unacceptable to all the biologists. As continuous variations were observed in nature, Mendel's concept of factor gene as stable and discrete unit was controlled an expression of characters, and that a pair of allele did not blend with each other was not accepted by biologists. Mendel also did not know the physical location of the factor or gene in the gametic cell. In 19,000, three scientists, Hugo de Veyrys, Correns and von Stechermark, independently discovered Mendel's work on the inheritance of trait. Due to advancement in microscopy, scientists were able to observe cell division and the structure of chromosome under microscope. Walter Sutton, along with Theodor Bohori, in 19,003 studied the parallel behavior of Mendel's factor or gene and behavior of chromosome at the time of meiosis. Based on these observations, chromosomal theory of inheritance. Question may be asked on this point. Write a note on chromosomal theory of inheritance for 2 or 3 marks. Point is, theory was put forth by Sutton and Bohori. Second point, this theory identifies chromosome as the carriers of genetic material. Then third point, this theory states that chromosomes are present in pair in somatic cells. Fourth, during gamete formation, homologous chromosomes pair, segregate and assort independently during meiosis. Fifth, thus each gamete contains only one chromosome from a pair. Sixth, nucleus of gametes contain chromosomes which carry all hereditary traits. Male and female gametes, sperm and eggs, carry all the hereditary traits. They are the link between parents and offspring. 9. The fusion of haploid male gamete and haploid female gamete restores the diploid number of chromosomes of the species. Always remember, gene and chromosome occur always in pair in diploid organism. Alleles located on chromosomes segregate along with chromosome during gamete formation. Can you recall what is chromosome? How many chromosomes are present in human somatic and reproductive cell? Let's hear what is chromosome. Chromosomes are filamentous bodies present in the eukaryotic nucleus. Second, the term chromosome, chromo means color and soma means body, was coined by W. Waldier in 1888. So this is important point. The term chromosome was coined by ... Correct answer is W. Waldier in 1888. The size of chromosome varies from species to species. Each metaphase chromosome varies from 0.1 to 33 mm in length and 0.2 to 2 mm in thickness. So this point is important. Question may be asked on this point, the length of chromosome is ... or thickness of chromosome is ... Chromosomes are visible during cell division. They are capable of self-replication and play a vital role in heredity, mutation, variation and evolutionary development of eukaryotic species. We know heredity means transmission of character from one generation to next generation. Mutation means sudden and abrupt change in genetic makeup causes different formation of different characters in the next generation. And variation means differences among parents and their offspring. Next point is chemically eukaryotic chromosomes are made up of DNA, histone and non-histone protein. The function of chromosome is chromosome are carriers of heredity. The number of chromosomes. The number of chromosomes is specific and constant for a particular species. Therefore, it is of great importance in the study of phylogeny and taxonomy of the species. The term ploidy speaks for the degree of repetition of the primary basic number of chromosome, that is X in cell. When the chromosome number in a cell is the exact multiple of the primary basic number, then it is called euploidy. Euploidy include monoploidy, haploidy with one set of chromosome where X is equal to N, diploid N is equal to two sets of chromosome, triploid 3N is equal to 3 sets of chromosome, tetraploid 4N is equal to 4 sets of chromosome, and so on. When the chromosome number is not the exact multiple of haploid set, it is described as uneuploidy. Uneuploidy is either addition or deletion of one or more chromosome or chromosomes. So the total number of chromosome in a cell, here polyploidy divided into two, euploidy and uneuploidy. Euploidy include monoploidy, diploidy means 2N, polyploidy 3N, 4N, 5N, etc. Uneuploidy include hypoploidy, hyperploidy. Hypoploidy are of two types, monosomy and nullisomy. Hyperploidy are of two types, trisomy and tetrasomy. Monosomy means 2N minus 1, nullisomy means 2N minus 2, trisomy means 2N plus 1 and tetrasomy means 2N plus 2. So these numbers are very important for exam. Question may be asked on these points. Monosomy contain chromosome number is, correct answer is 2N minus 1. Nullisomy contain chromosome number is 2N minus 2. Trisomy contain chromosome number is 2N plus 1. Tetrasomy contain chromosome number is 2N plus 2. Then, see our structure of chromosome. Question may be asked on this point. Explain structure of chromosome for 3 marks. So, diagram for 2 marks or 1 mark and description for 2 marks. Chromosomes are best visible under microscope when the cell is at metaphase stage. It is because at this stage chromosomes are highly condensed. Then parts of chromosome. It consists of chromatids. See here, these are chromatid. Chromatid 1, chromatid 2, chromatid 3 and chromatid 4. Then second, primary constriction or centromere. See here, this is the primary constriction or centromere. Then secondary constriction, first constriction, secondary constriction first, or it is also known as nucleolar organizer. Then chromonemata and chromomere. See here, these threads of DNA are known as chromonemata. Nemata means thread. Then chromomeres. Here the spherical structures are present on the chromonemata. These are known as chromomeres. Meres means beaded structure. That's a golakar je structure this day. Yala manaycha chromomeres. Then telomere. See here, tip part of the chromosome is known as the telomere. Then satellite. See here, this is the satellite. So these are parts of chromosome. Let's hear details about these parts. First, chromatids. Typical chromosome consists of two chromatids. Each chromatid is made up of many solenoid fibers. Each solenoid fiber is made up of many nucleosomal fibers. And each nucleosomal fiber is made up of many nucleosomes. And each nucleosome consists of 8 histone protein molecules wrapped by DNA molecules. So here these histone protein molecules are the chromomeres. Second point, primary constriction or centromere. Two chromatids are joined together at centromere or primary constriction. Primary constriction consists of a disc-shaped plate called kinetochore. It is at the kinetochore spindle fibers get attached during cell division. Then third point is secondary constriction first or nucleolar organizer and secondary constriction second. Besides primary constriction, some few chromosome possesses additional one or two constrictions called secondary constriction. At secondary constriction first, nucleolus become organized during interphase. या ठिकाणी secondary constriction first पासून nucleolus तयार होतो. Then chromonemata and chromomeres. Each chromatid in turn contains a long unbranched cylinder highly coiled DNA threads called chromonema through the length of chromatid. Chromatid consists of double-stranded DNA molecule which extend from one end to from one end of chromosome to other, that is chromonemata are threads of DNA present in the chromatids. A segment of DNA acts as a gene. Fourth point is chromomeres are beaded like structure present in the chromatids. They are made up of histone protein molecule. Then fifth point is telomere. Terminal part of chromatids are known as telomere. It avoids joining of other chromosome and thus avoid mutation. जर या ठिकाणी दुसरा क्रोमोसोम येऊन जॉईंट झाला तर त्या ऑर्गॅनिझम मध्ये वेगळंच कॅरेक्टर दिसेल आणि त्याला म्युटेशन असं म्हणतात. मग हा टिलोमियर काय करतो तर इट अवॉइड द जॉईनिंग ऑफ अदर क्रोमोसोम्स. द लेंथ ऑफ टिलोमियर इज रिलेटेड विथ द एज ऑफ ऑर्गॅनिझम. वेन इट इज डिक्रीजेस पर्सन बिकम एज्ड. आता या टिलोमियरची जी लेंथ आहे ती कमी कमी होत जाते. जसं माणसाचं वय वाढत जातं तशी ही लेंथ कमी होत जाते आणि किंवा माणसाचं एज होणं या टिलोमेअरशी रिलेटेड आहे. म्हणून याच्यावर संशोधन चालू आहे की ह्याची लेंथ कमी न होऊ द्यायची, त्यामुळे माणूस काय राहील, तरुणच राहील. देन सिक्स पॉइंट इज अ सॅटेलाइट बॉडी ऑर सॅट बॉडी. इट अटॅच ऍट सेकंडरी कॉन्स्ट्रिक्शन सेकंड इन व्हेरी फ्यू क्रोमोसोम्स. Then depending upon the position of centromere, there are four types of chromosomes. Metacentric, when centromere is present at the center, it is known as metacentric and the shape of metacentric chromosome is V-shaped. Question may be asked on this point. Shape of metacentric chromosome is V-shaped. Then submetacentric, when centromere is present just away from the centromere known as submetacentric and the shape of submetacentric chromosome is L-shaped. Then third point is acrocentric or shape is J-shaped. When centromere is present towards the end of chromosome then it is known as acrocentric and the shape of this chromosome is J-shaped. The next telocentric chromosome, the centromere is present on the anterior end of the chromatid known as telocentric chromosome and the shape is I. So these are the different shapes of chromosome. Then next point is sex chromosomes. The chromosomes which are responsible for the determination of sex are called sex chromosome or it is also known as allosomes. Human being and other mammals have X and Y chromosome as sex chromosome. X chromosome is straight, rod-like and longer than Y chromosome. X chromosome is metacentric while Y chromosome is acrocentric. X chromosome has larger amount of euchromatid, means chromosome material which does not stain strongly except during cell division. It represents the major gene and is involved in transcription and has loose chromatid structure. And small amount of heterochromatid means highly condensed region and inactive for transcription. Euchromatin has large amount of DNA material, hence genetically active. Y chromosome has small amount of euchromatin and large amount of heterochromatin, hence it is genetically less active or inert.